recitation today. In our recitation today, a good majority of it revolved around the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail in building the Kaaba. And his dua. And his dua, how it revolved around the supplication for his offspring, for his children. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our recitation today talked about the story of Prophet Ya'qub when he was about to die. And what he told his children before he died. He made sure that they believed in Allah. He made sure that they believed in the religion of Islam. He didn't say about his wealth, this much goes to this much, this thing. He made sure that their belief was upon Islam. But actually, the point I wanted to discuss with you is in the last page of recitation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the belief of the believers. How they believed in the previous messengers. How they believed in the same message as the previous messengers and prophets called to and believed in. Now, my brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blesses a person even in the way that he looks when he is sincere to Allah in his worship. What do I mean? I mean, for example, you can see a person, you never knew him from before. But you see him in the street, and you know, for example, that he's a Muslim. You never talked to him before. Just the way he looks. And those people that you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blesses the people when they're sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just in the ajr, but in their physical appearance, even. Even in their physical appearance. That you can look at a person and subhanAllah, you have inclination towards him, you like him. Just by the first look. Not talking about even the way he acts. It is extremely important, as we know, that our deeds we do to Allah is for His sake. And we know if it's not for His sake, it's a reason to have it rejected. But even more, when your deeds are for the sake of Allah, the effect is on the way the person looks like. Which leads to our recitation today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the recitation, صِبَغَةَ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبَغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the belief of the prophets and the messengers, the one God, their beliefs. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, صِبَغَةَ اللَّهِ. صِبَغَة refers to a coloring of the cloth, for example. To have something colored, to color your beard. When you get older and you have white, you color it. To add a type of sibgha, which is coloring. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He described the belief of Allah as sibgha. That means the belief has an effect on the way the person looks like. Automatically. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ سِبْغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ. And there is nothing greater than the sibgha, than the coloring of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing greater than that. When you have this coloring, when you have this belief and you're sincere upon it, its coloring shows on your face the same thing, your appearance, the same way the coloring affects the white clothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, صِبْغَةَ اللَّهِ, the coloring of Allah, the belief of Allah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ. And there's nothing greater than the belief of Allah, meaning the coloring of Allah, and we are the ones who worship Allah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us sincere in all of our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.